Hey folks, I am Mayur Santani, Product Manager on the Microsoft Authenticator app.
I'm Calvin Louie, Product Manager on Entra ID's Authentication Experiences team.
If you're interested in setting up a passkey and using it to sign in with your account, this is the video to watch. Calvin and I will walk you through registration and authentication experiences, first for passkeys in the Microsoft Authenticator app, followed by passkeys on a FIDO2 security key. Let's begin with registering a passkey in your Authenticator app. Signing into the Authenticator app is by far the best experience to register the passkey. It is our recommended flow, as the Authenticator app walks you through every single step you need to set up the passkey. Let's start with the experience when you first open the app. You'll go through the initial screens to consent or not to data use in the app. And then you'll have a choice of what type of account you want to add. Tap on Add Work or School Account, and then sign in. You can use any of your permitted MFA methods, but here's an example of signing in with a temporary access pass, or TAP, after which the Authenticator app checks your organization's policies on what authentication methods you're allowed to register. In this case, it's passkey and MFA push notifications in the Authenticator app. The app will then walk you through the different requirements, such as screen lock and enabling Authenticator app as a passkey provider. And then, at the end, you're set up for all the different Authenticator app credentials, including your passkey. You can also learn more about how to use the passkey both on the same device and cross-device. And you can also see additional details about the account and the passkey you just created as well. If you already have a work account set up in the Authenticator app, you can go through a relatively similar experience to set up your passkey. This time, you'll click on your existing account in the Authenticator app, in this case, passwordless phone sign-in, and tap on the Create a Passkey button. You'll see a screen with some information about what is a passkey and how it helps with authentications. Following that, sign in to verify your identity and go through the steps to enable a passkey. Since, in this case, passwordless phone sign-in was already set up, there isn't a screen lock prompt. Instead, we're taken directly to setting up the app as a passkey provider, and once that's done, the passkey is created and you will see a success screen. If this is your first time using a passkey, you can tap on How to Use a Passkey to learn more about how you would use the passkey both with another device and on the same mobile device. Your passkey is now ready to be used, and you can take a look at additional details of the passkey in the Authenticator app. Once you've registered your passkey, it's time to authenticate with it. Signing in with your passkey is very straightforward on the same mobile device. On the login page, you'll simply enter your username, and you'll be prompted to sign in with your face, fingerprint, or PIN. At that point, the operating system's dialog box will open up, confirming that you want to use your passkey to sign in. You will leverage your biometric or PIN to confirm your identity, and that's it, you're signed in. By the way, for potentially even faster sign-in, or if you have a long username, you can also sign in without entering your username. On the username page, you just tap on sign-in options, and then face, fingerprint, or PIN, and the rest of the flow on your mobile device is pretty much the same. You may be wondering, well, Mayur, how do I use the passkey on my phone to sign into another device, like a laptop? We've got you covered. On your laptop, navigate to the web page you want to access and enter your username. You'll be prompted to sign in with your face, fingerprint, or PIN, and the OS's dialog box will take over. Tap on, I want to use iPhone, iPad, or Android device, and once the QR code is open, scan it from your mobile device's camera app and tap on Use a Passkey there. Leveraging Bluetooth and the internet, the devices will establish a connection and the mobile operating system's prompts will take over. You will use your biometric or PIN and complete the phishing-resistant authentication on your mobile device. And that's it.
Awesome stuff, Mayur. Now you may be curious, how do I set up and use a security key instead? To set up a security key, navigate to your security info in the My Sign-Ins portal. Assuming you're accessing the portal on a Windows device, tap on Add Sign-In Method, then Security Key or Passkey. Passkey is the name of the credential that can be stored on a security key, desktop, or mobile device. Here, you'll see a dialog telling you about the benefits of passkeys and to prepare you for the security window that will pop up next. Once the security window from Windows or your operating system of choice pops up, find the security key option. Sometimes this is hidden behind a use another device choice, so keep that in mind. Next, you'll be prompted to perform user verification by either presenting a biometric gesture or, in this case, your security key PIN, followed by a physical touch of the security key. The last step is to give your security key a name so that you can recognize it later. Just like that, you're done. Now, let's take a look at how you can sign in to work with a security key. Sign in is quite simple. Enter your username as usual. If you want to go usernameless instead, you can click Sign In Options, then Face, Fingerprint, PIN, or Security Key. Otherwise, press Next after you've typed in your username. If Security Key is your preferred sign-in method, you'll see the security window pop up immediately after. If this is not the case, simply click Other Ways to Sign In and find Face, Fingerprint, PIN, or Security Key. Now, click on Security Key in the platform dialog. Perform your biometric gesture or enter your security key PIN, then touch the key. That's it. You're signed in and can move on with your day. We hope this how-to video was helpful. To learn more about passkeys, please watch our other videos. We're excited for you to join us on our passwordless journey. Thanks for watching.